Take us forward, sir, with your strength and your speed, so we may conquer all our battles and suppress all our goals. Whisper to us the words of further success, and scream to us when we stray from your path. Thank you once again, my Lord, for blessing our lives with this occasion, and for everyone who has made it possible. In your name we pray. Amen.
One thing is certain. A life lived in the past is no life.
Dad, thank you for everything. Over the last 4 years, as a class, we've seen about a little bit of everything. Beginning with our freshman year, it was the leap to 5A. And with the leap came School of Construction. For the first semester, a locker was probably the most priceless object around. And if you're lucky enough to have one, you probably had a few rather muscular seniors sharing it with you. The competition at this level is truly intense. Trinity tried to rudely remind us of that our freshman year, and they spelled out 4A at a home football game. But our day of revenge came this year when the scoreboard read Trinity 7, Grapevine 53. Our sophomore year was basically notorious for a bomb threat every other Friday afternoon. We were all herded out into the sweltering heat. And that year, it was also the year for the ice storms. Now, if all your memory is still intact, you remember a particular afternoon of an unscheduled early dismissal, and we all basically just slid home because of all the ice and snow. Our junior year, we saw the arrival of Dr. Gillum and the initiation of the environmental move. The visit by Dr. Goodall and the building of the Ecology Center are two events that none of us will soon forget. Then finally came our senior year and the plague of senioritis. As a class, we have the honor of being the last senior class of GHS to graduate as a four-year high school. We also enjoyed watching the building of a new junior high, and in return, we all got to sit around in the parking lot every afternoon. And to those of you who had seen the release, you're never going to know how much I envy you. Finally, the brightest and perhaps the most momentous experience of our senior year would have to be the state championship soccer 3 weeks prior. Thanks, guys. The last 4 years have truly been excellent. And a few years back, I had a good friend tell me, John, nothing lasts forever. But I think our days at GHS show that that isn't always true. Many of the accomplishments and the memories will live in our hearts forever. And along with the past, the hopes and dreams for the future will never die. Each and every one of us will make a particular dream become reality, and the memories will be passed on. So to you, the class of 1990, I leave you with this message. Don't let life pass you by. Grab hold and never, never forget to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. Thank you.
Thank you for our parents.
and support this day would not be possible. We thank you for their patience and understanding, for leading and guiding us, and for the encouragement that has brought us here today. And now, Lord, as we prepare for the future, we pray for your hand to be on every graduate here. Give us the strength to withstand the challenges of life, wisdom to make the right choices, courage to walk the right path, and love enough to share. We pray that you'll keep your eyes on us, on the things that matter, the things of you and your kingdom. And now, as we take our first steps on our separate ways, we ask that you guide us down our individual paths and watch over those who have brought us to this point. As we depart on the path that each of us takes as we leave here, keep us close to you. May we continue to discover your truth, wisdom, and goodness in all we will have you as part of our lives. Bless us, Father. Lead, guide, and protect us until we meet again. These blessings we ask in his name. Amen.
Gilbert Anderson. Rochelle May Anderson. Gina Joan Anselm. Stephanie Nicole Armstrong. Rebecca Gail Arnold. Mary Eugene Ashley Jr. Donald Ray Everett Jr. Sandra Lee Everett. Gina Raina Bailey. Terry Leanne Ballinger. Brandy Joe Aaron Barber. Laura Lee Barlow. Charles Arthur Bernard. Christopher Dean Barron. Jason Patrick Barton. Jill Anna Bates. Chad Elliott Bailey. Jennifer Lee Beavis. Jace Everett Beasley. Christopher Beetson. Alyssa Renee Bell. Mallory Ann Belfay. Daniel Price Berry. Candace Lynn Bishop. Sheila Renee Lang. Beverly Joyce Landon. Sarah Louise Lockwood. Sue Ann Angela Bowe. Shauna Rainey Boggs. Ryan Patrick Botch. Erin Colleen Bodie. Troy Reagan Boyer. John Alex Boyson. Michelle Lynn Grimm. Heather G. Preston. Patricia LaShawn Brewer. Christopher Neil Richter. Stephanie Ann Hennessy Bridges. Ann Michelle Brooks. Robin Michelle Brown. Zoe Melissa Brown. Cynthia Nissa Buchanan. Laura Ruth Buckner. Gregory Glenn Bullock. Brooke Elizabeth Boltman. Rebecca Lynn Burgess. Angela Burks. Gordon Mitchell Burns. Lori Lee Burns. B. Cecil. Jared Neal Chadwick. Frank Stanley Chambers. Zachary Ryan Chandler. Christian D. Chapman.
Jason Boyd Dominique.
Jennifer K. Hartnett.
Curry. Clinton Robert Curry. Nicole Renee Panisse. Ryan Adam Knight. Carl Wade Pokernot. James M. Lambert. Wendy Dawn Langford. Yeah.
Fishhauser. Christopher Michael Todd. Sonia A. Tony. Tracy Marie Torgerson. Carla Jean Torres. Justin S. Torre. Boyd David Tracy. Christopher Kyle Trahan. Tracy Lynn Trammell. John Christian Travers. Matthew David Travis. Denise Diane Trevino. Deandra Dawn Trissel. Sean Michael Tunnell. Brian James Twain. Jill Christine Tyler. Nicole Sherry Vonderlee. Rhonda Dean Banduzzi. TJ Barnell. Mike Vasquez.
Thank you. forever mindful of our responsibility to be all that we can be and to give of ourselves so the world will continue to grow in wisdom and grace. Bless and keep safe the people who are here with us tonight, our parents, teachers, administrators, and friends, all of whom have given us love, encouragement, and understanding. All of these things we humbly ask of thee, Lord, our Creator and greatest friend. Amen.
Join us now for the Grapevine High School Baccalaureate Services held Saturday morning, June 2nd in the Grapevine High School Gym.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us to gather here this morning. We thank you for the blessings you have given us that have enabled us to reach this moment in our lives. Thank you for all of our friends, family, and teachers who shared in the good times and pulled us through the bad times. As we part from these loved ones, protect us and grant us the strength to become independent and successful. Guide us in our decisions and help us to grow in faith throughout our lives so that we may become closer to you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. born of the flesh is of the flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto him, you must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is every one that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can this thing be?
On behalf of administration at Grapevine High School, I would like to welcome everyone to the baccalaureate program for the senior class of 1990. At this time, I would like to introduce the Reverend Johnny Miller, who is the minister of the First United Methodist Church of Colleyville, who will bring our baccalaureate sermon.
Good morning. Last year, Stuart Burton, who's our Minister of Music, walked into the staff meeting one day and said, congratulations. And I said, on what? He said, well, you're preaching baccalaureate service this year. And I said, I haven't heard about it. The school hasn't called you? I said, no. I said, you better call Miss Frank at the high school tomorrow and find out about that. So the next morning, Joy called the high school office and Carolyn answered the phone, and Joy asked Carolyn, is our pastor supposed to be speaking to the seniors this year, which was last year? Yes, ma'am, I'm so sorry. We just haven't had time to get with you, but he is now to speak this year. Do you think that he can do it? Well, we'll get back with you. That afternoon, Stuart called to see if I found out anything. I said, you're right, Stuart. I'm preaching. He said, well, did they offer me any sympathy or anything? I said, no. They said, show up on this time, this day, and preach. I said, okay. And then about that time, Stuart started laughing. I said, uh-oh. And sure enough, he had a full one over me. He called Miss Frank here at the high school early that morning and said, would you call my pastor and tell him he's doing the baccalaureate address? So I got out of that here. But I didn't this year. May we bow in a moment of prayer. Our Creator God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for these few moments we might share together a word of your gospel. We thank you for those who come today to be a part of this day, to be a part of this graduation, to be a part of this baccalaureate service. We thank you for their parents, who have walked with them, who have cried with them, who have rejoiced with them, who have pulled out their hair over them. And here we sit, asking that you would be with us and guide us. Because as brave as we seem to be on the outside, on the inside, there's still that nagging fear of what it's going to be like away from home. May you grant us the assurance in this hour that no matter what we do, no matter where we go, that you shall go with us. And help us, O God, in just these few brief moments to put aside the concerns, the joys of this day that lie before us, the anticipation of graduation this evening, that in these few moments we might be receptive and open unto your Spirit as you speak into each of our lives. And this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to share a couple of stories with you, and then I'm going to build some blocks with you, and then I'm going to ask you a couple of questions, and then I'll be through. As Julie read the scripture a while ago, it's about Nicodemus. And Nicodemus lived during Jesus' time, and he evidently was a very significant person at that time. We read that he was a Pharisee, which was one of the most devout Jews that lived at that time. They tried to obey every single letter of the law. We also read, as Julie read, that he was a ruler, which in all likelihood meant that he was probably a member of the Sanhedrin, of the highest court in the land. And then we read where Nicodemus came to Jesus by night one evening and said, Jesus, we know you're a teacher of God, or else you can do these wonderful miracles that you do. then the question is, how can you enter into your mother's womb again and be born again? And Jesus goes into his discourse about the wind and where